Boy, oh boy. Devil May Cry 2. Devil May Cry 2. Now, as most of you know, I try to avoid bad games on this channel. I try to pick games that I know I will enjoy playing through and games that you guys would love to hear my opinion on. Every now and then, I get a little experimental or curious and I try to play a game or a series that I don't really know much about. And sometimes we find a gem, and other times, eh. But this one really shocked me because I always assumed every Devil May Cry game were, you know, good. Now, as I get deeper into the Devil May Cry series, this seems to be the one game that even the diehard fans cannot defend. Maybe DMC2 is kind of like what Sonic 06 is for Sonic fans, but coming off an amazing game like DMC1, how bad could this really be? Right? I mean, DMC2 was originally released on the PS2 back in 2003, and now is readily available via the HD collection on modern hardware. One thing I can say about DMC2, I love the box art for this game. No, seriously, I really love the box art for it. I would go as far as to say it's probably my favorite art out of all the DMC games for the cover. So that's something, right? But as we start playing this game, it did not take me long to understand why this game was so hated. Now, I know this game went through director changes, it was rushed, you know, development hell at its finest. And man, does it show. But before we get into the game itself, let's take a look at that plot, or at least take a glance at it. The plot is essentially this. Dante and a new character who goes by the name of Lucia is on a mission to stop this demonic businessman who goes by Arias. His main objective is to gain unimaginable power and control by raising the demon Argosax. Along the way, we learn details on Lucia's origin and much more. Now, I won't spoil much of the plot here, but just like DMC1, the main objective is to stop someone from gaining uncontrollable power. That's pretty much it. Now, in terms of the characters, this is Dante after the events of Devil May Cry 1, so Dante is not necessarily the super confident, cocky Dante that we know. Instead, we have a much colder, no-nonsense Dante. Now, as far as characterization, I can imagine many fans may be split on his personality type. Some people really like the colder Dante, other people may not like it as much. Me personally, I didn't mind this version of Dante, but it did make the dialogue and cutscenes a little less memorable for me. You know what? I can kind of say that for most of the characters we meet in this game. Just not that memorable. Even Lucia, just nothing stood out to me. Now, the game. Gameplay. One word I can use to describe this game? Boring. I mean, seriously, the swordplay is completely simplified and uninteresting. You literally only have a 3-hit combo. The guns are overpowered, the lock-on system is just no, and the environments are just boring and bland as hell. I literally had to force myself to play through this campaign and was yawning throughout most of the experience. The enemies don't even put up much of a fight. Those aggressive enemies from DMC1? They're not here. I was literally just 3-slashing my way through the entire game. I mean, no. Even some of the missions, the way that they were designed, I just can't. You still find weapons as you explore, but trust me, you are not missing much. The boss fights were even bland, and for this review, I literally had to look up a list of bosses because they were that unrememberable. The only standout boss I could think of was the final boss, and even then, the challenge was just not there. And I could say that for almost every boss in this game, and yes, even the infamous infected chopper boss. I literally sat and just held one button down while shopping on Amazon and checking my phone. I'm not exaggerating, it's just, oh my god, no. Now, I could easily sit here and attack this game all day long, but I will give the game some props. One thing I can say, even though the guns are overpowered, I like how Ebony Ivory handles here. I like the fact that I can aim at two different demons, and I love how the guns feel in midair. I also like some of the traversal options Dante has here, most notably the wall running. Devil Trigger also makes a return, and I like the fact that you can customize the characteristics of Devil Trigger. That's pretty cool. Even though it's underutilized, I still like the option. Once you beat the game, you can play as Lucia, but if you're playing the HD collection, like me, you can select her from the very start. Listen, I refuse to play through this campaign again, so I just captured footage for the first few sections for Lucia, and I will say she does move faster, and I like her playstyle more than Dante's in this game. I also hear Trish is playable, but listen, I'm not even gonna bother to unlock her, so here, enjoy this footage. Overall, I cannot recommend you guys play DMC2. If you're interested in the story, just watch the cutscenes on YouTube. Do not waste your time with this game. Just don't. The next game we're going to be looking at in the series, listen, I can't wait for this one. That is DMC3. But until then, I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.